So starting with CARO company auditor's report order 2016. First we will refer to the section of the Companies Act which has given the power for the central government to notify the requirements, additional reporting requirements for the auditor. So let's start. In accordance with the provisions of the section 143 subsection 11 of the Companies Act 2013, certain class or description of the company shall include a statement on certain specified matter. So these reporting requirement on specified matters has now been prescribed under Companies Auditor's Report Order 2016 issued by MCA. So MCA now notified this auditor's report order 2016 on which the power is given by the section 143 subsection 11. So coming further, now is it mandatory to comply with this CARO 2016? Yes, the section 143 subsection 11 clearly says that the central government may order for the inclusion of statement on specified matter in the auditor's report for specified class or description of companies. Accordingly, CARO 2016 is issued by central government in pursuance of section 143 subsection 11 of the Companies Act 2013 as an additional matter to be included in the auditor's report. So therefore it is the additional reporting requirement which is the responsibility of the auditor to be included in the independent auditor's report. Therefore, it should be applied by the statutory auditor for every company on which it applies. So, it is the mandatory requirement for every statutory audit to include these reporting requirements in its independent audit report wherever it applies. So, it is important to note that we have to expertise in knowing that whether the CARO is applicable on a company or not. Now coming further, the applicability, from which financial year it is applicable. So CARO 2016 is applicable from financial year 15-16 and CARO 2016 is applicable for the financial year 15-16, financial year 16-17 and the subsequent financial years, and the matters specified therein shall be included in the each report made by the auditor under section 143 on account of every company to which CARO 2016 applies. Now we are coming to the applicability of the CARO 2016. So here is the CARO 2016 applicability. This sign means not exceeding. This greater than or cross is equal to, it means not exceeding in this chart. So applicability, CARO 2016 is applicable to every company including the foreign company, means it's wider scope. It is in wider scope. There are some certain exception to this. First exception is if you are a banking company, then you don't need to have to follow the CARO 2016 reporting requirement, but it is applicable to NBFC, but it is not applicable to foreign bank. And this banking company status is checked on the 31st March, that is the balance sheet date. अगर कोई company financial year between the financial year NBFC रही है लेकिन वो 31st March को as a banking company status registered हो जाती है तो उस पर CARO applicable नहीं होगा. और company का meaning यहाँ पर है, company means company registered under the Companies Act 2013. Insurance company means इंश्योरेंस कंपनी पे भी CARO 2016 अप्लीकेबल नहीं होगा. और जो फॉरेन इंश्योरेंस कंपनी है उस पे भी CARO अप्लीकेबल नहीं होगा. नेक्स्ट एक्सेप्शन आती है सेक्शन 8 NPO पे भी CARO अप्लीकेबल नहीं होगा. नेक्स्ट OPC जो इनकी 1% कंपनी, उस पे भी CARO की एडिशनल रिपोर्टिंग रिक्वायरमेंट कंपलसरी नहीं है. नेक्स्ट आता है स्मॉल कंपनी पे भी ये अप्लीकेबल नहीं होगा. स्मॉल कंपनी की डेफिनेशन दी गई है सेक्शन 2 सब सेक्शन 85 में दी गई है. इसमें कहता है कि स्मॉल कंपनी मींस अदर देन ए पब्लिक कंपनी, मींस कंपलसरी हैव टू बी ए प्राइवेट कंपनी. और इसके जो रिक्वायरमेंट्स दी गई हैं जो इस मॉनेटरी वैल्यू में है वो कि पेड अप शेयर कैपिटल शेल नॉट एक्सीड 50 लाख एंड टर्नओवर शेल नॉट एक्सीड 2 करोड़। नेक्स्ट इज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड कंपनी। कारो इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल टू प्राइवेट लिमिटेड कंपनी इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ एंड जो उसके साथ कोई कंडीशन अगर सेटिस्फाई होती हैं तो प्राइवेट लिमिटेड कंपनी पे कारो एप्लीकेबल नहीं होगा। लेकिन इसमें नोट करने वाली बात है कि जो कारो है वो कंपलसरी एप्लीकेबल है अगर कोई प्राइवेट लिमिटेड प्राइवेट अनलिमिटेड कंपनी यानी कि उसकी लाइबिलिटी अनलिमिटेड है जो कि अनलिमिटेड होती है जो शॉर्टफॉल ऑफ एसेट होता है जो शॉर्टफॉल ऑफ एसेट टू पे द लाइबिलिटी। तो ये अनलिमिटेड कंपनी इंडिया में बहुत ही रेयर होती है मतलब है ही नहीं। तो प्राइवेट लिमिटेड कंपनी के बारे में बात करते हैं। जो प्राइवेट लिमिटेड कंपनी है कि नॉट बीइंग ए सब्सिडरी और होल्डिंग ऑफ पब्लिक कंपनी मींस ए प्राइवेट लिमिटेड कंपनी शुड नॉट बी ए होल्डिंग और आइदर ए सब्सिडरी ऑफ ए पब्लिक कंपनी। इफ इट इज़ ए होल्डिंग और सब्सिडरी ऑफ ए पब्लिक कंपनी देन कारो विल बी कंपल्सरी एप्लीकेबल टू दैट एंटिटी। नेक्स्ट क्राइटेरिया इज पेड अप शेयर कैपिटल प्लस रिजर्व एंड सरप्लस दैट इज PRS पेड अप शेयर पेड अप कैपिटल रिजर्व्स एंड सरप्लस शैल नॉट एक्सीड 1 करोड़ एज ऑन बैलेंस शीट डेट। नेक्स्ट कंडीशन इज बोरोइंग द बोरिंग ऑफ दैट प्राइवेट लिमिटेड कंपनी शैल नॉट एक्सीड 1 करोड़ एट एनी टाइम ड्यूरिंग द फाइनेंशियल ईयर। इट इज़ नॉट एट द टाइम ऑफ बैलेंस शीट डेट एंड इफ एनी टाइम ड्यूरिंग द फाइनेंशियल ईयर द बोरिंग क्रॉसेस 1 करोड़ then CARO is compulsory applicable to that private limited company. Next condition is revenue. The revenue of that private limited company shall not exceed 10 crore on the balance sheet date including the revenue from discontinued operation and it is checked on the balance sheet date. Next coming further we will have to check the what is the meaning of this paid up share capital and what it's include in reserves and what will be included in the revenue. So coming further to the next chart, CARO 2016, what paid up share capital includes both equity share capital and preference share capital. Next is reserves and the both paid up share capital are checked on the date of balance sheet that is 31st March of every financial year. So reserves means capital reserve includes revenue reserve, security premium reserve, revaluation reserve, all other reserves, but does not include the provisions and debit balance of the surplus shall be reduced from the revenue reserves only. Total revenue here it will be taken on the date of balance sheet and it is taken as per the schedule 3 requirements and it includes the revenue from the discontinued operation and revenue from the operation and other income like interest income, dividend income and cash discounts it includes, but excludes the commission, the taxes paid like GST, VAT or CST etc. and excludes the sales return. So it is all about the CARO 2016. Let's revise quickly the main points. CARO is applicable to every company including the foreign company but does not apply to a banking company, insurance company, section 8 NPO, one person company, small company and private limited company with certain exception, but it is applied to private unlimited company. Next come further is paid up capital includes equity share capital as well as preference share capital and reserves include capital reserve, revenue reserve, security premium reserve, revaluation reserve, all other kinds of reserves, but does not include provisions and debit balance of the surplus should be excluded, reduced or deducted from the revenue reserves only, and total revenue includes the revenue as per shown as per schedule 3 and includes the revenue from discontinued operations and revenue from operation, other incomes like interest income, dividend income, cash discount, and excludes the commission paid on the sales and taxes paid on the sales and excludes the sales return. So it is all about the CARO 2016 applicability, which is very important for a company and auditor who is reporting under the section 143 of the Companies Act. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to our channel, Professional Gyan. Have a nice day. Thank you.